After 16 years of campaigning and conflict, the palace has been put back into the pier. The new pier owner will rename the attraction to Brighton Palace Pier after huge public support backed by an Argus campaign.
There's an awful lot of love and affection for the old palace name, but we also want to maintain the new and the modern, and we want to very much maintain the link with Brighton. We feel, particularly in overseas advertising and out of Brighton advertising, that the Brighton name has tremendous power. So we thought the best of two worlds, Brighton Palace Pier. We're looking to work with far more local companies to use local entertainment to really forge stronger links with local Brighton people and local Brighton talent. We've been talking recently to Small Batch Coffee Company, very famous local company. We've been talking to the Lane Brewery. They're brewing us our very special Brighton Pier Ale at the moment.
Renaming the pier is just the start of its makeover, with the aim being to retain the 1940s appeal of candy floss donuts and rides, but bring it up to date to reflect a Brighton that's modern and bohemian. Brightonians say these are welcome changes. They want to preserve the romance of the old pier they've known and loved since childhood, and pier owners are hoping the new name will resonate with both tourists and the local community.
I think it's a good idea. Supporting local businesses. Excellent. Yes.
That's the name I always knew it by. It is the Palace Pier. I don't know why they call it the Brighton Pier. When I was a kid, we'd come down here with my parents on holiday and we stayed in a guest house for a week. And that they had the West Pier was functional then and used to have a theatre. It would be nice if they had a theatre here as well.
It's always been known as the Palace Pier. So there was the Palace Pier, West Pier, and that was all we ever had. Well, I used to fish at the end of the pier as a kid with my brother and my dad. And I think the problem now is you've lost all that. And it would be nice just to keep that little bit of romance and not make it too modern, because looking at the I-360, it's gone too modern, you know, and I think it's spoilt the seafront.
Now with the soon-to-come locally brewed pier beer, coffee and gourmet dining options on offer, the city's greatest attraction hopes to retain its historic value and embody the taste, sounds, smells and spirit of Brighton. This is Marion Lanis for Latest TV News.